Hi, in this video I'll show you how to make a simple DC to DC boost converter. The input can be anywhere from 9 to 15 volts and the output you can obtain a maximum of 60 volts by this design. It can be easily modified to obtain a higher voltage by simply changing the components. The circuit is based on the relaxation oscillator made up using two transistors. I'm using the B239 because they have some good power outputs. The frequency is set by the value of the resistor R1, R2 as well as the capacitor C1 and C2. The capacitor C1 controls the on time of the transistor Q1 and the capacitor C2 will control the on time of the transistor Q2. Basically what happens is that the transistors will switch each other on and off, and so you can make use of this to drive a DC to DC boost converter. For the MOSFET you can use the IRF540. It's rated for 100 volts and a current of about 28 amperes, which is good and enough for this project. When the transistor Q2 is on, the transistor Q1 will be off, and so there will be a VCC reference at this point, and this will cause the gate of the MOSFET to be pulled up to VCC and the MOSFET will conduct. When this happens, current will flow from the input through the inductor R1, through the MOSFET and to the negative rail or ground. Energy will begin building up in the core, and the voltage of the core will be in a manner such that you have a positive here and a ground reference at this point. After some point, the transistor Q2 will turn off and the transistor Q1 will turn on, and so you have a ground reference at this point, and so basically this will cause the MOSFET to turn off. Because an inductor tends to keep the current flowing through it stable, this will cause the potential across it to reverse in a manner such that you have a negative here and a positive here. When this happens, the diode D1 will be front biased, because if you look at it, the inductor and the input, it's right there in series configuration. When the diode D1 conducts, it will change the output capacitor C3. The resistor R6 is a minimum load which prevents the output capacitor from overcharging, and also it discharges the capacitor once the input has been withdrawn. To adjust the output, you can use a resistor divider network and a small potentiometer. By varying this potentiometer, you can change the voltage required at this point to cause the transistor Q4 to conduct, and so control the on time of the MOSFET Q3. By controlling the on time of the MOSFET Q3, you can control its duty cycle, and because the output voltage is directly proportional to the duty cycle, you can alter the voltage of the output. If you want to use this as a voltage booster for voltages less than 50 volts, you can use the IRF-Z44 because it has a smaller resistance and can handle more power. Just keep in mind that you do not exceed the output voltage of its rated capacity of 55 volts. You can also replace the B239 with any other NPN transistors. Select the components of the resistors R1, R2 and capacitors C1 and C2 in a manner such that it will cause the relaxation oscillator to oscillate at a frequency of at least 20 kHz. The design frequency is from 25 kHz to 50 kHz. For the inductor, ensure that it can handle at least 5 amperes, and the diode can also handle at least 3 amperes and an inrush of at least 5 amperes. The 6A2 is written for 6 amperes and 200 volts, which is good for this project. The output minimum load resistor R6 is written for 3.3 kΩ and at least 2 watts. The capacitor also should be written at least 1.5 times the required output voltage. Thank you for watching, and I hope you liked this video. If so, make sure to give it a like, share and subscribe to my channel for more amazing projects and tutorials. Have a nice time, and I'll see you in the next video.